Hello, I'm Susan Guthrie of Divorce in a Better Way, and today I'm going to share with you one of my top tips as a leading mediator to help you when your ex won't budge when you're trying to negotiate. So this happens all the time in negotiations, right? Whether it be a divorce negotiation or any type of discussion where you're trying to come to a resolution, very often you will hit a point where both sides sort of dig in their heels, right? In mediation, we call it impasse. This point where it just seems like everyone's locked into what they want, and those two things are so disparate that there's no way we're going to ever bring them together. Now, if that were true, that once we hit impasse, no one was ever going to be moved forward, mediation wouldn't actually be very successful. And in fact, negotiation wouldn't be very successful. But in fact, you know, as many of you have heard me say in other videos, over 95% of divorce cases go to judgment with an agreement. So somehow people are able to move past that hard line position. So what's the way to do that? What are you supposed to do if you are trying to work through an issue with your ex so that you can get to resolution and they are just stuck? They're like, I want what I want and that's it. If you don't give it to me, I'm not gonna settle. And that's it. So you are stuck in that position of either accepting something that's not acceptable to you or giving in or you know, giving up. So here's the tip. And it's very simple, but it's actually a miracle worker, I think you will find. So you start with the question, why? Now that sounds simple, but what you're going to do is, instead of focusing on what your ex says their position is, I want this, you're going to ask them, why do you want that? What is it that you see? What are the interests that you have that you are supporting with the position of what you want, you know, why you're asking for what you want? The magic word is why, because what that does is switches the conversation from I want this to why I want this. And when you know why they want it, you can start to see if you can craft something that is going to meet those whys, those interests, as opposed to the hard line of it's this or nothing. Because what you find in negotiation, in mediation, which is essentially a negotiation, in a divorce negotiation where it's going on between your attorneys, or you're just sitting at the kitchen table trying to talk to your ex about how you're going to resolve things, you cannot resolve when it's just, I want this and I want this. But when you know what it is that the whys of what your ex is asking for, then you know what is incentivizing them and what you can try to give them while still getting as much of what you want as possible. So the first step is always saying why. You know, so as an example, your ex says, I want 50-50 custody. And that's it. That's just this phrase. I hear this one all the time, actually, in mediations or in negotiations. 50-50 custody, it's got to be 50-50 custody. But when you ask them, why do you want 50-50 custody? You're going to hear a variety of things. I want to have regular and constant contact with my children. Why? I want to be sure to see them several times per week. I don't want to be minimized in their lives. I want to be there for all, you know, major events. So you start to drill down, and I would say you don't say why once. You say why as many times as you can until you feel that you have exhausted their whys. So now you have a nice list, and I always think it's a good idea to actually write these things. This is important. This is important. This is important. And then here's the next step. Once you've done the whys and you've drilled down on all the whys, you say, so if we can come up with something that addresses all your whys, that gives you what you want in your whys, that's different from 50-50, but still addresses everything you say that you want, all your whys, could we come to some resolution? Would that be acceptable? Now, it would be very hard for someone to say no to that, because they've now just, like, you know, last question you ask them before you get to that is there anything else, right? So now they've given you a full and complete list of why they want something, and you're giving them the idea that there might be another way to come to that. And you've now armed yourself with a great deal of information for you as you are trying to come up with possible solutions that will meet those needs, as opposed to it's got to be 50-50 custody. So that is the key to everything. Everything in a negotiation or a mediation always needs to be switched from a position-based discussion, which is I want this, I want that, to a needs or interest-based discussion. And the magic word that does that is why. So I encourage you, when you get frustrated or you get to a point where you feel like we're not going to be able to move any further in this negotiation, remember to take the word why, the question why, out of your tool bag, because I think you're going to find that any impasse can usually be met when you break down the I want into the this is why I want. So I hope that helps you all move forward with your negotiations and to divorce in a better way. For more tips and resources, please visit my website, divorceinabetterway.com. I have a number of additional videos on the YouTube channel, a lot of resources from friends and colleagues around the world that are there to help you. And you have the ability to reach out, ask me questions. I will do my best. I am not currently doing mediations myself, but I have a large number of colleagues and friends around the world and country who I can hopefully introduce you to if you are looking for an online mediator. So I'll see you soon, and thank you.